So for example, if I want to change the background color of the body element, and by the body element, I mean, so this white color, I want to change it. So this is the body element. I want to change the color to another color instead of using this white. So for that, I will select the body, and then I will use the background property, which will help me to change the background color of this specific element, which is body. So I have three ways, or I have three solutions. So the first one is by using a keyword color, and by keyword color I mean you can use red on yellow. So I'm not here defining this keyword, they are already defined by the language. I can use brown, or I can use green, and there are multiple ones. But the problem is, what if I want to use a lighter color, a lighter green color, or a darker green? So for that, I need to use another format, not this simple one, not this one, which is a keyword. I need to use another presentation, which is an RGB presentation or hexadecimal. Okay, let's just start with the first one. The first one is the RGB presentation. So this is a function. I'm not creating this function. This is a CSS function, which will help you to just change the color of the body of any element by specifying some values. And this RGB is just, this is red, green, and blue. And the minimum values that you can put, we have three values separated by comma. And the minimum value is 1, 1, and 1. Sorry, not 1, but 0, 0, and 0. Now, if I save that, you will see that this is black. If you put three zeros here separated by a comma, so it just mean that this is a black. This is a black presentation, or this is the RGB presentation of the black color. And the maximum one is 255, 255, and 255. Now I'm using the white color. Now what if I wanna have another color? So from VS Code or Visual Studio Code, I have this palette here, which when I can navigate through colors, and the value of red, green, and blue is changing depending on the color that I want to use. Now, for example, if I'm going to the darker color, you see that the value is changing, and the RGB, now I have a new presentation. And this presentation is helping me to get into any color that I want to change. Okay, and the other interesting thing when you are using the RGB presentation, if you want to just reduce the opacity of a specific color, so it will just add another pop. Now we have 1, 2, 3 for RGB, air, red, green, and blue. And the third one is for the opacity. If you want to just reduce the lightness of the color, reduce the opacity, if I'm just putting 1, so 0.1 means that I'm going into the lighter color. And if I'm just using 1, I just keep so the color without reducing the opacity, and I can just reduce that by 0.1 if I go 0.9 or 0.7, so until 0. So 0 means nothing, but if you just want to decrease the opacity of a specific color, you just need to add a specific value. But if you are not interested with that, just keep it, keep the format of the color like that. Now, let's just move to the other, presentation. We have, as I already said, the RGB presentation, okay, which has three values. Now save that. We have the RGBA presentation. The last one can be for the opacity. Then we add a value 0.4 as an example, and just to reduce the opacity. And for the last one, we have the hexadecimal. So the hexadecimal presentation. And for example, let's just save that and use only RGB. And if I hover over that, and I can change the value to an hexadecimal value. When I'm clicking here, when I'm using Visual Studio Code, it changed the format of the code. Now I'm using another presentation, and this presentation is a hexadecimal presentation. It starts with the symbol right here, then we put a hexadecimal code. And you don't have to memorize all of that. So there are some tools that help you to get you into a specific hexadecimal color. Let's just go, for example, for green. Now we are changing the color, and you are free. So this hexadecimal presentation is also, it's shorter than the RGB, and so feel free to use any format that you like. But in general, so if you want to just go to RGB, you just need to click here, then click on RGB, and you have an RGB presentation of this color. So let's just duplicate that. Yeah, copy that, And for this color right here, the presentation, this is the hexadecimal presentation, and this is the RGB presentation.